All right, let's talk about the flow of a cost system. Now, remember, in a non-manufacturing company, you've got one type of inventory, cost of goods purchased. In a manufacturing enterprise, we've got three different types of inventory. What we're going to be looking at is what we call raw materials or stores control inventory. We have work in process, we have finished goods, and then that goes to cost of goods sold. So what I want to do is kind of set up the flow of a cost system so we can understand how these costs are flowing through. So we start out with our raw materials, then work in process, whip it good, then our finished goods, and then costs of goods sold. All right, so raw materials, we have some beginning plus purchase equals raw materials available. Raw materials available. We're gonna have minus some ending equals raw materials used or raw materials requisition. Now notice that this is generally direct materials, right? Not indirect, but this will be your direct materials. So that is called your raw materials used, raw materials requisition. Now this is called raw materials. It's also, as I said, sometimes called stores control because we're storing our inventory there. Then, work in process. Now, we start out with some beginning work in process, plus, whoop, bring that in, that's generally our direct materials. This is where you add in your direct labor. Now remember we said we're using a what kind of system? A normal cost system, which means we're gonna use actual materials, actual labor, but we're gonna use some overhead. What kind of overhead, anybody? Applied overhead, because we don't know how much actual is yet, it's applied. Now, remember, this is applied overhead. How did we get this? We took our estimated cost over estimated dollars equals a predetermined rate per whatever times actual production equals what? Equals your actual overhead. So you can see here your actual overhead, that goes into where? Work in process. Now, come on down, what was the journal entry? We debited work in process, credited overhead applied. This is for the overhead. Where did this debit go? This debit came into WIP right here. Okay. So that gives you your WIP available minus ending work in process equals something called cost of goods completed or cost of goods manufactured. Manufactured or completed. And they'll use either of those words. Don't confuse it with cost of goods sold, because they haven't been sold, that's completed or manufactured. So then let's come over, I'll move this over a little bit to finished goods. So with finished goods, we have some beginning finished goods plus cost of goods manufactured or completed equals finished goods available minus ending finished goods equals cost of goods sold. That'll then come over to here, cost of goods sold. Now notice, you bring this in, cost of goods sold, plus this is where you adjust for your over under. Remember over here when we had over or under applied? What happened is we applied 300, we actually spent 5, we closed these out, the difference went to cost of goods sold right here because we were under applied. So, let's bring it back down. That's going to be plus your under applied or minus your over applied equals the real cost of goods sold number. So notice in a manufacturing company, they have three types of inventory. Raw materials inventory, because it's raw materials ending, work in process ending, finished goods ending, and then the rest goes to cost of goods sold. That's when it becomes an expense. Okay, so when we talk about a product cost, you're capitalizing it. Notice this is ending product cost, ending product, and then finally you sell it, it becomes an expense. So the words I want you to note here, I want you to notice some important words. Some of the words deal with things like, boom, raw materials used or requisition, that's generally direct materials. Here you've got cost of goods manufactured or completed, those flow into finished goods. Here is your cost of goods sold. Don't confuse these two, cost of goods sold, cost of goods completed or manufactured, because they'll ask you about the differences between the two, so it's important to understand. Again, that is the flow of the cost system. That is how we're flowing and that as we go through. Now, realizing again that at the end, this is going to be what we applied. This is the actual over here. That's where we adjust for over, under applied. That is what's going to account for our overhead variance. It's either we spent too much, we were less efficient, our production capacity was down, something went wrong. That's why we're over or under. So again, to understand the flow of the cost system, that's how it all ties together. But I want you to see how this predetermined overhead rate, that ties into coming up with this entry. Here's actual, here's the difference. That's under applied. That's where we're increasing our under applied for cost of goods sold over here. Boom. This is the flow of the system. Remember this. One, two, three types of inventory. If I'm just purchasing a pen and reselling it, I have purchases. That's it. If I'm manufacturing and I got raw materials, inventory. Work in process, inventory. Finished goods, inventory. And then what do? You whip it good. All right, look in your notes. You'll see there in your notes the flow of the system. And it's, again, everything is beginning plus some purchase is available minus ending is boom, right? Beginning plus you added some is available minus what's still here is what went away. Where did it go? Into WIP. Where did it go? Into finished goods. Where did it go? Cost of goods sold. So the stuff went away, it went somewhere. Looking in your notes, you'll see it says to determine direct materials used, beginning plus purchase minus ending is used. Beginning plus purchase minus ending is used. So that's that. The next formula, cost of goods manufactured, is this. Next one is cost of goods sold is this, and it flows into there. That's where you have to adjust for over and under. Turn the page and you'll see a paragraph that says the most common base. The most common base. So look for that paragraph for about page, I don't know, 4, 5, 6, the most common base. The most common base is direct labor hours, blah, 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 direct labor dollars, blah, 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 machine hours. I bolded those words, direct labor hours, direct labor dollars, machine hours. So in looking at them, the ones that are most frequently tested, direct labor hours, direct labor dollars, that's what we're using as our base in order to apply it to get the predetermined rate times actual equals what you're applying into WIP. Because remember, you're applying this right here into work in process as you are working. That's why we multiply it times actual production. The problem is we don't know what the actual bill is. We haven't gotten our electricity bill yet for the month. So I don't know what it is. But I can guesstimate, it's about $1,000 a month. Let's take that, divide it by how many units we usually do or how many hours we normally work. We normally work $1,000. We work 1,000 hours. That's $1 an hour. So for every hour she works on that, I'm going to add $1 for overhead. That's how you're doing it. And then at the end, we've got to adjust because we may be over or we may be under. So that's important to understand as far as what? The flow of a cost system. In a minute, we'll do some questions and test this stuff out.